to You by Puffin.
Cappy and the Whale by Kateryna Babkina. Translated by Hannah Leliv and read by Roy McMillan. Illustrated by Yulia Polipchatina. To my mother, to Bogdan when he was little, and to Tanya Shapochka, Maria and Dasha, and everyone who is fighting. The Whale Who Eats My Pills. One morning, I glanced out of the window and saw a whale floating in the sky. The whale was blue and grey, large and clumsy, yet he was just rolling along and gliding on the warm, sunny breeze with surprising grace. I grabbed Mum's phone from her desk to take a picture, but the whale arched his back and dived into the treetops through the early spring leaves. Small birds fluttered up, chirping angrily. While I was in the hospital, I read every book in the world about animals. Well, not every book, it was actually 23, but that's still a lot. I read about this fish that can crawl on land during droughts, about the platypus that digs a burrow underwater, and about the monster living at the bottom of Loch Ness in Scotland. And about the 52 different types of flying fish that have fins big enough for them to speed up and leap out of the water and glide over the waves. But none of these books mentioned a whale being able to swim in the air, high up above the park, in the late afternoon. That evening, Grandma took me out for a walk. I looked and looked into the green gloom of the early night sky. The darkness tangled up in the rustling bushes until I felt dizzy. Grandma got scared. She thought I'd grown weak again and had fallen asleep standing up. But I couldn't help staring up at the treetops, trying to catch a glimpse of the huge whale up there, moving around, hiding, breathing in and out. When we got home, Grandma fussed around trying to take my clothes off so she could check my body for new bruises, but I hate that. I'm not a little boy anymore. Before I went to the hospital last year, I broke my swimming coach's nose when he tried to help me hurry up and change into my swimming trunks by pulling off my underpants. He kept shaking his head and laughing at me as he wiped away the blood. I was in no laughing mood, though, because I couldn't stop thinking about what Mum was going to say. When the coach told my Mum what had happened, she listened carefully, and then, after a long, silent drive home, she said to me, "Adults should never take off your clothes or touch you in a way that feels uncomfortable. But if they do, like when Grandpa pinches your nose, there's no need to punch them. In fact, you shouldn't punch anyone." But then, after she'd thought about it a bit more, she added, "But actually, you did everything right." So then I had even less idea what to think. The coach and I had a talk, man to man. We agreed that he would never touch my underpants again and that I wouldn't touch his nose. Then he gave me a small hourglass to keep in my locker. It measured time. I had exactly 3 minutes to change into my swimming trunks. Every time Mum took me to the locker room, she'd see the hourglass and remember the broken nose and laugh. Later, my coach brought me that hourglass while I was in the hospital, but that time Mum burst into tears. There's nothing scarier than seeing Mum cry, when blue-black tears run down her face. I'm not scared because of the blue-black, I know it's only makeup. I get scared because she seems to shrink when she's crying. She grows smaller than me, becoming so tiny and fragile that I don't know what to do with her or how to protect her. I'm okay when Mum gets angry, though, because she grows big then, big and angry and strong. I'm glad that Mum didn't cry or yell at me when I punched my coach. I think he liked her. I'm sad I stopped going to the pool. So, anyway, back with Grandma. I went to the bathroom alone and took off everything I was wearing except my underpants and checked my arms, my shins, my bottom and my back in the mirror. I didn't see any bruises. When you get bruises like mine, you don't feel good. You can barely keep your eyes open, and if you hold your breath and blow all the air out and squint slowly, it feels like you'll become so light that you could fly right up off the ground. That never actually happened to me, though. I just fell down, once back in kindergarten and one time in the locker room at the swimming pool. That was when Coach saw all my bruises. Grandma was waiting for me behind the door. I told her I was all right, but that I wanted to be alone, so she went back to the kitchen and I plugged the drain and started to fill the bathtub. I had to think over all the things that had happened today. The water was chilly, but not freezing cold like in winter. The pipes in our apartment block had warmed up now it was spring, and the water inside the pipes too. I wondered, could a real whale in an ocean somewhere get so hot in springtime that he would jump out of the water and just float up in the air carefree? Or maybe it was something to do with global warming, like the bright yellow waves in my atlas. Would those waves get bigger and bigger, hotter and hotter, brighter and brighter? And then would all the whales and dolphins and sea mammals feel too hot and start living up in the open air, floating around in cities like shiny blimps? That would be so neat. But how would the whale stop himself from falling down? I knew that the beluga whale is the smallest whale in the world. It weighs about 2,000 kilograms. That's twice as heavy as Dad's Toyota. His car needs an engine with the power of 135 horses to start it moving, so it would take way more horses to get it up in the air. That's why our car can't fly, Dad had explained. So how much horsepower does a flying whale need? The one I saw wasn't a beluga, so he's not even small. I was also pretty sure the whale didn't have an engine or propeller. Could a whale be hollow? Just a superlight shell kept up in the air by warm winds like kites and birds with big wings? No. I knew that a whale couldn't be empty. People used to hunt them for their meat.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.